Hello, I'm Mikael Rinne. Thanks for having me here. Let's dedicate a moment for fractures. Everything will fail, especially artificial man-made objects and structures. This talk deals with fractures and failure. Mushrooms, it's a bit similar phenomena as fractures. We know they will appear, but it's very challenging to predict accurately where, when, and how they appear. Fractures are always essential, for example, to shape the wedge of a Stone Age axe requires good idea of different rock types and how they respond to load. When splitting firewood or when we open a can, we deal with fracture propagation. When we wish to have a productive well in the bedrock, we wish to have a lot of water-filled fractures there. Fracturing is needed in all stages of rock fragmentation, including rock excavation, crushing, and grinding. Many new applications like geothermal energy, CO2 sequestration, and nuclear waste disposal are examples where a good command of rock fractures is needed. Unwanted fracture propagation is also something we need to handle. We all have experience of breaking a glass and know that brittle failure can be very violent as the fracture quickly propagates through the material. In deep underground mines, high stresses are present in the rock mass. New fractures may initiate in the intact rock, leading finally to a failure. When the stress level is very low in the rock mass, like in rock slopes, the existing natural fractures play the main role in the failure process. Because loose rock blocks may slide and cause a progressive failure of the rock mass. Fractures are also important for water flow, especially in the crystalline bedrock. In geothermal energy production, fractures are needed between the boreholes where the cold water is injected into rock mass and the heat is extracted. For nuclear waste storage, fractures' ability to transport water is of concern. When spent nuclear fuel is disposed, it still generates heat. This will cause warming of the surrounding rock mass, leading to thermal expansion. And that leads to increase of stresses. The question is, will new cracks initiate and propagate in this new stress state? And will these new fractures connect with existing natural fractures? I started my doctoral studies at KTH, Stockholm, Sweden, where I completed my licentiate thesis in 2000. With my supervisor, Professor Uwe Stefansson, and his student, Dr. Bao-Tan Shen, we developed a fracture propagation code, later named FRACET. My licentiate thesis dealt with development and verification of this model. The long-term stability of the rock mass is of interest, especially for the nuclear waste management. The classical fracture theory states that fracture is stable until it reaches a critical load. After this critical limit, it propagates very fast. The longer the fracture is, the easier it may propagate. Related to my doctoral studies at TKK and KTH, my team developed the model to consider this slow fracture propagation called subcritical crack growth that may lead to time-dependent or delayed failure. My doctoral thesis combined the subcritical crack growth theory with the classical fracture propagation theory. This concept was also implemented in the numerical code. I start as a professor at TKK in 2008, successor in rock engineering after Professor Pekka Särkkä. I have been lucky with good doctoral students and postdoctoral researchers. So far, five doctoral projects have been completed. My topics mainly deals with, surprise, surprise, fractures and rock failure, mainly related to mining or nuclear waste disposal, but also geotechnical risk assessment and energy storages in rock has been studied. Digitalization is progressing fast also in rock engineering. We utilize, among others, photogrammetry and virtual reality. Photogrammetric model, it is possible to make fracture mapping, including measurements of fracture dip and strike and fracture surface properties, all safely in the office. We also utilize this opportunity in teaching for remote learning. From a very accurate fracture surface model, it is possible to estimate surface properties like roughness that correlates strongly with the friction. Machine learning is also something that we have started to study, mainly to identify fracture traces from photographs. I hope this talk highlighted some aspects of fracture mechanics. Fracture mechanics help us to design safer, environmentally acceptable, and economical solutions for many rock engineering challenges. Thank you.